Hey guys, Jules here for WhatCulture.com, and I want to talk to you today about DC and Marvel crossovers. Now, if I was to say the phrase, "I didn't mean to hit him with my car," then... Oh, wait, sorry, that's the wrong script. The phrase, Marvel and DC crossover, then it would sound really strange in this day and age, wouldn't it? However, it's actually something that's happened more than a few times across the years, and when you've got two universes packed full of characters and villains, it's a shame that it's not happened more. And the best part is that when these worlds do collide, that they're usually f***ing mental. So let's take a look at some of the best today, shall we? Yes, we shall. With this in mind, I'm Jules from WhatCulture.com, and these are 5 Marvel DC crossovers that you won't believe exist. Number 5. Uncanny X-Men / New Teen Titans. Any comic that contains Wolverine, Deathstroke, the Phoenix, and Gorilla Grodd has to be doing something right, even if it was likely a fresh hell for the artists involved. In fact, it would be pretty much perfect were it not for the sheer amount that is thrown into the span of 65 pages. There's 2 different plots for the X-Men and Teen Titans respectively, a side plot with Robin, a pre-plot, subplot about the Phoenix, and several different potential romances. Seriously, I've seen easier Kama Sutra positions. Despite this clusterfuck approach, there are some seriously badass moments, and all are accompanied by some extremely well-written segments. Plus, I mean, it's got Starfire and Colossus kissing, so yeah, that's a thing. Number 4. Superman / Fantastic Four. Beautiful comic covers aside, seeing Superman fight both the Fantastic Four and Galactus in one comic is a wild and luxurious treat. It also contains maybe one of the weirdest plot twists a crossover has ever had, as in within the Marvel Universe, it's revealed that Superman is real as a daytime cartoon. It's never officially been denied as canon either, so we can actually dream of a universe where Peter Parker still watches Batman with his cereal every morning. It creates some utterly memorable moments, like when Reed Richards basically no-sells a cartoon character hanging out in his workshop, as well as Franklin Storm showing off just how much of a fanboy of Superman he really is. It's mental, but utterly brilliant stuff. Number 3. JLA / Avengers. Having these two teams meet up is a bigger collaboration than my member and your mum's back passage. There's my one per list. And also, it is so worth a read. Seeing the mascots from each universe going at it is as fascinating as you might expect, creating some of the most intense scraps around. It's basically like Christmas for comic book fans, and while we know that fighting isn't the only thing you should be reading comics for, it certainly helps when they're this f***ing good. Number 2. Just Imagine series. Seeing DC superheroes reimagined by Stan Lee as they would have been if he had made them is just very cool. And they're not simple rehashes either. Clear time and effort has gone into creating figures that are clearly the ones we know and love, while still playing around with the backstories and characters enough to make it something new and exciting. Now, Stan Lee does often tread into cliché territory, but here it's actually quite surprising at how fresh some of these reimaginings feel. It's certainly not a conventional crossover by any means, but that's what makes it feel all the more special. And number 1, DC / Marvel All Access. The only thing better than a universe crossover is a universe crossover that has a clever and thought-out plot. DC Marvel All Access has this, and it has the added bonus of introducing a new character part-owned by both companies. Because of this shared responsibility, we managed to get something unique from this crossover, a series that took its time to tell a story. Across its 4 issues, we got enough time to give each of the main characters time to shine, and thanks to both DC and Marvel giving their best writers and artists to the project, All Access stands as not only a clever, but beautiful read that genuinely begs the question, so, lads, when's the next one?